This story happened to me very recently, and for me, this was the only way I could lift the weight off my shoulders. First of all, I live in an urban part of New Delhi, India. I come from a family of Hindus that are highly religious. About a year ago, a close family friend passed away in a freak bike accident and unfortunately succumbed to his wounds. This was a great loss to everyone, especially my father, who was best friends with him. Now, we had to perform a ritual on his one-year death anniversary, which would free his soul to the astral plane. This is because spirits of people who died before they were supposed to do not want to leave this world. So, a few days before this ritual was supposed to happen, I woke up at night and went to get a drink of water. Now, my floor is connected to the third floor where my parents live via a flight of stairs inside the apartment. So as I was going to the kitchen, I always had to pass by the stairs. When I was coming back with the water, I looked at the stairs and I could make out the silhouette of a man. Now, I just thought that it was my father, as he would often come to check on my grandfather at night, as he had just come back home after a surgery. So I just said, "Good night, Dad." But as I was going back to my room, I noticed he didn't say anything back, but was just standing still at the top of the stairs. At the time, he and I were having a fight, so I just chalked it up to him ignoring me and went to sleep. When I woke up the next day to have breakfast, my father was at the table. So I asked him why he was just standing on the stairs last night, and he said he wasn't. In fact, he said he had so much work that he didn't once come down to check on my grandfather. My grandmother was at the table and overheard our conversation, and immediately said that it was our friend's spirit trying to make contact with us, but that we should never acknowledge his existence, as people with untimely deaths often take one of their loved ones with them. She then asked me if I had made contact with him, to which I told her the events of last night. She was relieved when she heard this, because the spirit must have thought I was talking to someone else, because I thought I was talking to my father. She made me go and pray, but I could hardly focus after all that she had said. And to this day, I wonder what would have happened if I had gone upstairs to take a closer look.